Hi, I'm John. This is my show, American Scheme, where I'm proving that Diana Ross is Michael Jackson's actual mother. Okay, so I'm gonna explain. I think I got it though. Dirty Diana. I think I got it. I think I actually understand now the whole thing of what Dirty Diana is, and so I'm gonna do it. Here we go. The explanation, the real explanation of what Dirty Diana is. So I need to give you a couple little bit of a history lesson really quick. I'll tell you really quick what I think the song is about. So Dirty Diana, I'm saying, is actually about Diana Ross and Smokey Robinson's relationship, okay, who I believe are Michael Jackson's real parents. So it's about their relationship, about Diana and Smokey. So what I need you to see here, this biography here, this would be the biography of Claudette Rogers Robinson. So this is Claudette Robinson. This is the woman who married Smokey Robinson. So now what it says there is, it says they were married on November 7th of 1959. So that would be a little bit over a year after Michael Jackson's born, right? Smokey has married Claudette. The other thing is, I know that Claudette, when Smokey Robinson met Berry Gordy, which would be in August of 1957, which would be basically 1 year before Michael Jackson's born. So I know that Claudette's in the band at that time, and I know that she's dating Smokey. So they would have been dating there for 2 years prior to the time when they actually got married. So this is the key to the whole thing. Is that Smokey, the whole time, he's dating Claudette back when they're young. And, you know, they get married, I think Smokey, I think he's 19 there, when he's in 1959. I think Smokey's 19. So Smokey got married to her young. She's a little younger. And they're in a relationship. This is the key to the whole thing, because when you hear this, this is the proof of everything of what I'm saying. And now that I've actually got the Dirty Diana, the explanation with all this, it has the perfect, and it explains everything about everything. And you'll see that Dirty Diana has to be about that. I can show you parts of that too. But first of all, you need to hear this part here. Listen to what Diana says.
And who was your first love, though?
Okay, so they specify man love. Oh, I should have specified man love. Man love. That means real. Like, who's the first man you're really in love with? So she says Smokey Robinson right there. I really loved him. And so now what I'm saying is, Diana Ross is young. At the time that Smokey Robinson is married to Claudette, Diana Ross is only 15 and a half. Then they were in a relationship before that. So what, Diana was like 13 and a half at the time when that we know that Claudette's in a relationship with Smokey. So where, it's like, but see, Diana's there. Diana's right there. She's in the neighborhood, everything. She's right there. That's the thing, though. But this proves to you that the date of what Diana, and see, this is, Diana is a woman. She's an adult woman here, and that's the other part too. See, now this would be on the Arsenio Hall show. So now Smokey Robinson has divorced Claudette. He divorced Claudette in 1985, I believe, 85, 86. So this would be a little bit after that. So Smokey has officially divorced Claudette by this time now, right? So Diana has said this, but then you come to this, and it's like, okay, this is Diana Ross and Smokey Robinson in 1985. So this would be basically when Smokey's relationship's ending, and you know, they've probably already separated at this time, because when you see this, it's like, geez, I hope they've already separated at this time. I know they're not officially divorced yet. I think it's 86, and this is 85. And when you see this, it's like, okay, so now you gotta imagine, Diana Ross is talking about Smokey Robinson as her first love, and she's talking about it as an adult, and so that's a real love. And then when you would think, well, maybe it's some little kid thing, but no, it can't be, because look at how they react together here.
He is very responsible for my career. I've been missing you, baby.
I've been missing you, too.
Miss you.
She's giddy. She gets really, they both are. They're like joined at the hip, You see how they're sitting there? Whew, she's getting hot. See, look at it. Ooh, she's getting hot. More, another kiss. Look at how happy they love each other. Okay, that's real love, okay? So that's not just some, like, made-up thing. Whatever that is, and the thing about that is, how does that happen? Because Smokey's just getting out of his relationship with Claudette. You know, they were married, I think it was 27 years. So he's just getting out of his marriage. Diana Ross, in a few years after this, she's referring to Smokey as her first love, okay? So it can't be this time. It can't be that she got an affair at this time. And then if she actually had an affair, if she was actually sleeping with Smokey, like, let's say it just developed that way. Let's say that that's how the relationship is that she's talking about. Okay, if she's talking about an affair, would she be talking about that on the Arsenio Hall show? Would she say, oh, that's my first love? Why would she mention back to something that she was participating in if it was an affair? Okay, so it can't be. And then when she says a first love, so it's showing you that her love has to go back all the way back to right when I'm saying when she's like not even 14, right when I'm saying when she got pregnant with Michael. And that's why it's so dramatic and so prevalent in their relationship, because they're, what they have is that she was got pregnant by him, and it's the Michael Jackson, and you can see it when you have a better understanding of the story. So now I'm going to explain to you the song Dirty Diana, because you guys had to have that information first. Now I'm going to actually explain to you Dirty Diana. You never make me stay, so take your... Okay, so you'll never make me stay, so take your weight off. So this is, I just figured it out that the whole thing, it's Smokey, because I thought Michael had some, this is where I was making the mistake. I thought Michael was participating somehow in this, some part of his point of view, but it's not. It's Smokey. He's giving it from the point of view of Smokey's point of view. It's Smokey Robinson and Diana Ross is basically primarily what's going on here. So it's Smokey telling Diana Ross, you're never make me stay, so take your weight off of me. And the reason is because Smokey's hooked up with Claudette. So he's telling Diana, you're never going to make me stay, okay? And he's saying, take your weight off of me. The reason that Diana has the weight is because she was the mother of the kid, of Smokey's kid, which ended up being the Michael Jackson. She would not have any weight on him, you see? Why would Diana Ross have any weight over Smokey? There is no reason for that, except for my story is what explains it all. Wait off on me. I know your every move. You know, I know your every move. So won't you just let me be? Because Diana's known, or Smokey's known Diana since she's like 8 years old. They're like best of friends. They lived just down the street from each other. They totally know each other. So he's like, I know your every move. He knows her inside and out. He really knows Diana Ross. And he's saying, won't you just let me be? Because he's in a relationship with Claudette. And he's telling her, there's no chance. It's not ever going to happen between them. I've been here times before, but I was too blind to see that you seduced. You know, so he had been there with Diana so many times before, you know, but he was too blind to see because he was young and naive at that time. He didn't understand the seduction of the woman, of what it was coming at him. And so you seduce every man, you know, this time you won't seduce me. So that's like, as it kept coming on, Diana kept holding that weight over Smokey and she kept like pushing him. And this is like Smokey, like telling her, this is like Smokey stepping away and demanding he's going to be his old thing. Diana's going to be her. Smokey's going to do his own thing. You know, so she's saying, now this would be Diana Ross talking back to Smokey. So she's saying to him, she's saying, that's okay. Hey, baby, do what you please. See, they know each other so well. That's why this relationship is so, it's so friendly and it's so familiar between them. Do what you please. You know, I have the stuff that you want. I am the thing that you need. So this is the way Diana Ross talks, you know, because she's seductive over these men. And then also now she's got Smokey. She's gotten pregnant by him. So she's gotten in there. She really has the stuff that she has the truth, you know. I am the thing that you need. She looked me deep in the eyes. She touched me so deep. Yeah, so she looked me deep in the eyes. So this is Diana looking at Smokey. And that's why she looks so deep in his eyes. And so she's touching me so to start. And then that's how she's just seductive. And that's what she does with Smokey is she just touches him. And then just with the way she touches him and a little thing, that's all it takes is for to turn him on. Here's how she seduces him, just a little touch. She said there's no turning back. She got me. And then that's how she tells Smokey, she says, there's no turning back, you know, making it clear to Smokey, she trapped me in her arms. She trapped him. See what I'm saying? She seduced him and had the kid. Because if she just has sex with him and there's no kid, there's no real trap. It's just a little thing. But the way that this, when she's, see how this is Diana Ross, the boss. And that's why Diana Ross got the boss, because this is the way she was. This is the way she has power over them. And she would not have this power if there's not the kid thing and all that stuff. There's none of this power there that, and you can clearly see Diana has some power here. Okay. That part. Okay, let's go that part. That's that part. Okay. She likes the boys in the band. She knows what they're gonna come. Every musician's band after the curtain. Okay, so this is Diana Ross, and it's really important of understanding, because when they talk about the groupie, because it's Diana Ross being the groupie to Smokey. Smokey's the guy that did everything, and he was the path to Motown, and everything came through that. And then so it's like, so when Michael's saying that, he's talking about Diana Ross, she likes the boys in the band. She knows when they come to town, because she's stalking after them. She's looking for, because you got to remember, this is also it's a song, and he has to put off the image of like a groupie image, right? But he's directly, when he's talking about she, it's directly Diana Ross, you know, that she's the one that follows the boys in the band. And then so every musician's fan after the curtain comes down. So it says that she's, not only does she like them, that she's sexually willing to please these guys after the show. Okay, she waits at backstage doors for those who have prestige, who promise fortune and fame, a life that's so carefree. And so this is Diana Ross. It's like the gold digger type of thing, where she's getting her way in. It was one of the things that she didn't matter that Smokey was hooked up with Claudette. Diana was getting her way in there. She was going to force her way, and she just did not care, because they had prestige, and she was going. She wanted to be famous. You know, so that's how it goes. You know, Diana's a realist, you know, do what you want. Because she knows she's there. She's there working it. That's her thing, the sneaky snake lady, you know, always there working the seed. So, you know, I'll be your night loving thing. I'll be that freak that you can taunt. You can play with me. You can mess around with me. You know, you can, you know, that's what Diana's telling them. You can take it. I'll be the freak you can taunt, you know. And that's the key right there, if you make me a star. So, you know, Diana, I don't care what you say. I want to go too far. That's Diana. I'm getting out of the ghetto. I don't care what you say. It's determination. It's a take no prisoners attitude. I'm going to win all the way. And Diana Ross had that, and she will admit to it too. The whole way, she has said, you got to go the whole way. You got to push. And then so, I'll be your everything if you make me a star. It's the whole key to the whole thing. She wants to be a star. And who made Diana Ross a star? It's Smokey Robinson. It's the whole thing. It's Smokey's the one who made her a star. He's the one who's responsible for her whole career, everything. Diane, that's the one part where I think he really clearly says, Diane, and then because he says, Diane, yeah, come on, because Diana Ross's actual name is Diane, with an E at the end, it's not A, it's with an E at the end, Diane Ross, and right there, I think he really does that thing where he says, Diane, yeah, come on. That was like his thing with making it more clearly about Diana Ross. The little insider things that he does, you know? She said I have to go home, 'cause I'm tired, you see. Now I can't sleep in alone. What? OK, Okay, so Diana Ross is talking to Smokey Robinson. This would be basically they're out on tour, you know, type of thing. They're out on tours, and this is like how Diana Ross kept seducing Smokey. There was a thing where she was always seducing him. The whole time she was always seducing him, always, you know. And then she moved into the, with the Berry Gordy, the relationship. And there, I was thinking there was something relationship with that, but I think that the song It's All With Diana and Smokey is actually what this song is actually about, their relationship. So it's Diana, she said, I have to go home because I'm real tired, you see. Now, I hate sleeping alone. Why don't you come with me? So that's Diana seducing Smokey, you know. And see how nice she is. Oh, I have to go home. You know, I'm tired. Won't you come with me? You know, I don't hate sleeping alone. Yeah, that's how it would be. Diana tried to seduce Smokey.
I don't come with me. I send my baby at home. She's proud.
And then, so this is Smokey because he's got Claudette. And this I was always confused before because I wasn't sure who, when they were saying, I said my baby's at home. I wasn't sure who the baby was, but now I got it. It's Smokey talking. And when he's saying my baby's at home, it's Claudette because he's married. He said my baby's at home. She's probably worried tonight. I didn't call on the phone to say that I'm all right.
I'm worried tonight. I didn't call on the phone to say that I'm all right. Diana, what not to me? Just sound on your tonight. And now I'm ready to the phone saying, baby, I'm all right.
Except
I'm not the
dope. So Diana walked up to me. Said I'm all yours tonight. Then I ran to the phone saying, baby, I'm all right. So that's what happened. Diana came up to Smokey there in this situation. And baby said, just like, come home. I want you bad. I'm all yours tonight, right? So Smokey then runs to the phone and tells his wife, okay, baby, I'm all right, you know. And then he says, I said, but unlock the door because I forgot the key. And what he's saying there, actually, that term, when he's saying unlock the door, I forgot the key, he's actually saying, unlock the door because I don't know what time I'm going to be home tonight. That's actually what he's saying because of this. Yeah. And then so then Diana said, Diana tells this to Claudette. She's like basically staying over the phone. So you have Smokey on the phone with his wife. And then you would have Diana saying, she said, he's not coming back because he's sleeping with me. See what I'm saying? And then that's how she gets the name Dirty Diana. So it's Dirty, the rest of it's just Dirty Diana, right? In other parts, yes, it's all Dirty Diana stuff. So that's Dirty Diana. That's what it's actually about. It's Michael Jackson talking about his parents, and he's calling Diana Ross dirty because the whole part of how Michael Jackson was born was out of this dirty love affair of what Diana had done of seducing Smokey Robinson while Smokey Robinson was hooked up with Claudette the whole time she's married. But Diana's right there, and then you could see that there had to be a love relationship going on because when you see them, you see Diana Lost later proclaiming that Smokey was her first love, and then you have them performing together right at the time when Smokey and Claudette are being in the divorce basically thing, and you can see that Diana and Smokey are like really like in love with each other. They've got some weird connection going on. And then so then the other thing is like Dirty Diana, people think that this song is about Michael Jackson and Diana Ross. And one of the clear things I say is like things about like here, I make a couple clear statements. I say, first of all, if it was about Diana Ross, Michael Jackson would have not have used the name Diana because Diana Ross is such a big star. Just by using that name, people were going to assume that there was a connection to her. So why would he do that? It would for him to go, because, you know, we're talking about just the real world. They're not family or nothing. They're just friends. So for him to do that to her and be in their relationship, for him to put the label of the Diana, I'm saying that it's something super dramatic, and I don't think he would have ever, because it was going to be so obvious, and with the dirty, there's no way he was going to call her Dirty Diana. I think it's really crazy, because look at how easily he could have just changed it to Susanna. Dirty Susanna, oh, Dirty Susanna. Dirty Susanna works perfectly fine. He could have just changed it to Susanna. Could have been any other name. So the fact that he used Diana was specifically used Diana. And then what I'm saying, if it was Dirty Diana, if there was a point in Michael Jackson's life where he's reflecting upon being abused and seduced by Diana Ross, right? If that had ever occurred, then there's no way that Diana Ross then ends up in Michael Jackson's will. Then their relationship wouldn't evolve back to a form of which Diana Ross would be in Michael's will as a guardian over Michael's children, because Michael would have had a turnover here, and he's a lot younger than she is, you know, 14 years different. And at some point then he's calling her Dirty Diana. See, seeing how this song is so seductive, right? And he's saying, you seduced every man, you time you won't seduce me. Okay, if that's Michael speaking it to Diana, there's no way she ends up in the wheel. If Michael is just making a song and he wants to use a random name, there's no way he uses the word Diana, because he wouldn't have done that to Diana Ross. Okay, so this song is important, and I was never really sure, but it's the telling of the story of Diana Ross seducing Smokey Robinson. That's what's going on in the Dirty Diana. It's because it's Michael Jackson telling about his parents and how he was formed through the Dirty Diana. That's Dirty Diana.